Greetings, friends. Sonic Toast here with another Monstery Monday. And today we are looking at the Funko Pops of the Universal Monsters. Now, these are not the original Funko Pops. They've done the Universal Monsters before. This is a new set that has come out recently. And so we're going to look at these and see what they're all about. Unfortunately, I've not been able to collect the whole set. I've got all except for the Wolfman, which is too bad. That's like my favorite Universal Monster. But yeah. We're going to look at, well, it says Frankenstein. It's actually Frankenstein's monster, right? And then we have the Bride of Frankenstein, and we have Gilman, which this is news to me because I thought he was just a creature from the Black Lagoon. I never knew his name was Gilman. I had to talk to my brother about that. My brother Lou, he's like a Universal Monsters expert, and he explained to me that in the sequel, he was referred to as Gilman, right? And tell you the truth, I haven't even seen the sequel of The Creature from the Black Lagoon. And then here's Dracula, of course. Everyone loves Dracula. So here they are out of the box. And one thing that's really cool I just noticed while taking them out of the box is on the flap on the top of the box, it has the logo for what movie they're from. So there's Dracula, and here's the logo for The Creature from the Black Lagoon. This one says, of course, Frankenstein, and of course, The Bride of Frankenstein. So we'll start by looking at Frankenstein's monster, and a really cool approach from Funko here, as they went with sort of a neon colored look for these characters, as past Funko Pops of the Universal Monsters have been very muted, very almost black and white looking, right? Trying to capture that old school movie feel, whereas they went the opposite direction with these ones, trying to make them really pop with color, no pun intended. I think the pose here is very classic and they did a great job. Same thing with the Bride of Frankenstein. The blue skin look is really interesting and all the color in her hair is kind of neat. I do feel like her hair could afford to be a little bit longer, but that would probably throw her off balance. I don't know why, but this just reminds me more of Morbius from the Spider-Man cartoon show in the 90s than it does Dracula. Something about the blue color all around him. But overall, it is just fine. It's a fine sculpt. And this is probably the best one of them all. Gilman, the creature from the Black Lagoon. All the sculpt, all the detail on him, it just looks fantastic. He looks terrifying. He is just great. Like, this is, if I had to choose one in the whole set, this is the one that I would choose. So that's really all I have to say. If you like Funko Pops and you like Universal Monsters, these are a great way to get into the Halloween spirit. If you don't like Funko Pops or Universal Monsters, then these aren't for you. But I do have something that I want to show you. So this is a shelf I am in my living room. It is a work in progress right now, but these are all Halloween themed Funko Pops. So this will be the perfect home for these Universal Monsters for the month of October. So we got Frankie and his bride right there in the corner. You may remember we did review Nosferatu or Count Orlok in a previous Monstery Monday earlier this month. So maybe we'll just put Drac here, hanging out with the other vampire guy. And then we have the creature from the Black Lagoon. He's really cool looking. I don't know, we'll just put him right here in front. Like I said, it's a work in progress. I feel like I could do more to make it all look better. Here it is so far. I don't think I'll be getting any more Halloween Funko Pops this year, but this is who I've got. I think maybe I need to add some more like gravestones or spooky trees or something.